On Masters of Spin this morning, Burger King does it again. The American hamburger chain, well known, of course, for its social media prowess, and it was quick off the mark with Harry and Meghan splitting from the royal family by offering them, quite graciously, jobs-flipping burgers.
Awesome. On Twitter, Burger King posted, "Harry, this royal family offers part-time positions." For Meghan, it wouldn't be her first time after making a burger-flipping video for Men's Health magazine in 2013. Oh, I've never seen
quite
that one
the
before.
Video, yeah.
Our Masters of Spin are here, advertising and marketing experts Dee Madigan and Matthew Bywater. Welcome to you both. I like this, you know, and I would have thought if you were the royal family, why not make fun of yourselves like that? She's an actress. She could pull it off, right, and say, give us some part-time work.
Yeah, look, they have to be careful about buying into it, but I think they'd secretly love it because it's done with charm and humour and it's on brand for Burger King. When things like this happen, all ad agencies, all the creators quickly say, how can we do an ad that taps into this? But Burger King, this is so on brand for them. They've been so good on social media and I think this is just great and fun.
Yeah.
What's your take on it, Matthew?
I like it, and I think it softens the negative side. You know, we'll talk about the Queen and what's her response, and there's not much she can say. I think she said all she can say. We're sorry they're leaving, but you're still family. But this softens the image. It puts a sort of humorous side to it, which is the best you can do in this situation.
What about the PR damage more broadly to the royals as a result of this split? I mean, how lasting is that? How substantial will that be?
this is interesting. The royal family economic is so important to Britain, as we were discussing earlier. I think so that's important, I guess, from the British
from
public.
From the tourism, like so many tourists. There's nothing else to see in Britain, really.
Yeah. But it's a kind of bit of modern family as well. I think, you know, the Queen, and some blame the Queen for this, because back in the 60s, she was the one that brought the journalists back into the Buckingham Palace and said, have a look at our family, trying to make it more look more real and more lifelike. And that created that celebrity status of the royal family. So they kind of invited this in of themselves. So that's part of the upside and downside.
I guess
you want to still keep it real.
I guess for the Queen, she couldn't win keeping everyone locked out.
Yeah.
And once you invite in, you have to take the bad with the good. But there seems to be a lot of sympathy for the Queen, having been through what she's been through this year at 93.
Been a tough year, hasn't it?
She's also Prince Andrew's mother. And I just, you know, I just think you sit back and you think, how do you raise someone who lacks such self-awareness? You know, I think her brand is damaged a little bit. But having said that, the British are incredibly sentimental when it comes to the royal family, so she'll be fine.
Yeah, I still think people think about her, though, that she is out almost every day of the year. She is still working. You know, she's literally dedicated her life to service, and it's been a pretty crappy end of the year.
To say the least.
Oh, I don't know. There's other people who do service more. They don't have palaces and servants and stuff.
Well, that's true too.
It does make it a little bit easier. Really quickly, I want to ask you about this latest road safety campaign. The rain starting to put out the bushfires, which is great. Queensland's emergency services have launched an anti-flood campaign targeting people driving through floodwaters.
Just go, seriously.
Just go around them.
Now, back it up. When you're faced with floodwater, the smartest and bravest thing you can do is back it up. If it's flooded, forget it. Search Back It Up today.
Matthew, just quickly, every time there's a flood, we report on the dangers of people becoming trapped. Do you think this campaign will actually make a difference?
I hope so. It's an important message. It probably lacks some impact for us. I actually get the ingredients, and I like the quintessential Aussie guy in a four-wheel truck. He's the one that says, nah, mate, we're not doing this. I think that message is great. Probably lacking a little bit of impact.
You don't know what's happening in it. Like, I watch it and I'm like, what? And it's one of those things where you don't have to show every target market to talk to them, and that's what they've tried to do. I think it's the strategy's right, the execution idea is not.
Right, okay. I did like the fact that he was showing how easy it is to get
but
out. That bit kind of gets you.
It's social norming.
Except you think he's the guy at the front of the queue. That's what I thought.
It's a fraction
confusing. And then you're like, well, how do you back it up? And then you realise he's on the other side. So it's confusing. Yeah.
All right, thank you both.
Dee, pleasure.
Good to see you. Still to come this morning, happy 98th birthday, Betty White. Wow, she's amazing, isn't she? As the celebrations spark a battle for her affections between Sandra Bullock and Ryan Reynolds.
And how they're bringing back an Australian film classic. This bush.